Namaste YouTube, welcome to Cafe Enoma and welcome to our reaction to Asia. We are going to react to the song Heat of the Moment.
We will also be reacting to MATCHBOX 20 and Dan Fogelberg. We just hope Dan Fogelberg's reaction goes online in one piece because it's someone we've never heard before.
Yeah, band we haven't artist, reacted before.
And it's from a different label than the ones that are usually go online smoothly. So we are saying that in advance. Hopefully it goes online. Asia, Heat of the Moment. That's what we are starting with. To learn more about us, you can check out our Patreon page. The link is in the description box of this video. And if you're short on time, you can find out a bit about us and our channel through the description box itself. Let's get started. Asia, Heat of the Moment. First time listens to all these three songs.
Yeah.
One thing I said that I would never do, a look from you and I would fall from grace, and that would wipe the smile right from my face. Do you remember when we used to dance, and incidents arose from circumstance? One thing led to another, we were young, scream together songs unsung.
It was the heat of the moment, telling me what my heart meant. The heat of the moment showed in your eyes.
And now you find yourself in 82. The disco hot spots hold no charm for you. You can't concern yourself with bigger things. You catch a pull and ride the dragon's wings.
Cause it's the heat of the moment. The heat of the moment. The heat of the moment.
Showed in your eyes.
Everyone was at the A game.
must have gone viral at that time. Whatever viral meant in those days.
Yeah.
Sounds like it's from the 80s, early
80s. Yeah, there was mention of
82.
Disco,
yeah.
82. What is that 82 about and related to disco?
I don't know. I guess the disco fever was...
The high in 82?
Or going down in some parts of the world.
It had just started. We have a song, Disco 82, which is very popular.
Yeah.
Disco 82. That's how I said 82 and then disco coming with it. What is it with it? But I like the song. I like the vocals a lot. And who shone in this heat of the moment in this song was the drummer. The things that he was doing. I don't know who all noticed it, but I noticed everything that he was doing. Almost everywhere.
You noticed as in you heard it.
Yeah, I heard it. I was listening to the drumming and the things that were done. I like the keyboard. I like the guitars and everything. But what was done on the drums was phenomenal.
I love the chorus. I love the song construction, the musical arrangement. I love the way the chorus went, you know. Heat of the moment.
You feel like singing.
Nice, you feel like singing along.
It's a sing-along.
So it's a beautiful song.
Yeah.
Enjoyable tune, enjoyable chorus. Great drumming. I like the song. I like the song. It's about being, when you're young, everything happens in the heat of the moment.
I know.
You don't really make long drawn plans, you know. Even today you have all the apps in the world, the youngsters,
yeah,
they have all the apps in the world, the kids and the youngsters, but still in the heat of the moment they do the same things like we used to do 20 years ago, 30 years ago, 10 years ago, whatever it was.
Mm-hmm.
The same things that we would do, they do in the heat of the moment. So that's about that, you know. And this person is growing older and older.
Yeah.
By the end of it, he's lonely by the phone.
I know, thinking about the
you know, all those times gone by. What did you get out of it? The heat of the moment. What did you get? Living in the now kind of thing as a mindfulness expert.
We talk about heat of the moment mainly in the reference of, fights, in the reference of arguments and problems, quarrels. But here, heat of the moment was for everything. You know, just in the spur of the moment, we did so many good things, sometimes not so good things. But what mattered was, I didn't mean to harm you or hurt you. It just was that way. Sometimes angry, sometimes happy memories, sometimes unpleasant memories. It was all in the moment that we were doing. We were being careless. We were being carefree at times. Whatever worked for us, whatever gave us happiness at that time. But that heat of the moment and heat from our body kind of, you know, mellows down, goes, recedes slowly and disappears beyond a point. And you will be sitting by the phone alone waiting for someone to ring you or something like that. The other day I was talking to my mother and she was saying, nobody calls me unless I pick up the phone and I make a call to them. I said, I do. I generally do. I'm the one who does. She said, not you, but other people. I said, look, not too many people call me as well. And I'm young.
That must have worked out. And I'm young.
I just wanted to draw a comparison. Look, you're not the only one in that boat. You are old and maybe not wanted. Wanted. So, heat of the moment, where is it? I don't know.
You know, the way things are going with the senior crowd,
yeah.
You know, very soon calling a person old also will be like using the N-word or F-word. So, you can't do that. You can't do that really. It's getting to a point, me in counseling, I come across many clients in the senior citizen age group.
Yeah.
So, calling them old is kind of offensive. It always hurts them. No matter how well they seem to be growing older, how well they are taking it, it always hurts them when they hear that word old. Especially
because, you know, everything comes flooding to your mind. This is a picture of old age. And I don't want to get there.
Yeah, so you're right. The younger days, obviously, in the heat of the moment, you kind of remember the days when you're young. And in the heat of the moment, you do so many things without thinking. Really, and you're still alive today, you know, kind of. So that is, when you're still alive, to talk about it, look back, think about it.
It's like Rose from Titanic.
Tells you that it was worth it, didn't it? Next song is If You're Gone by MATCHBOX 20. We'll get right to it in 8 seconds or less.
Yes.
Same video.
Namaste YouTube, welcome to CAFE ENOMA and welcome to our first time single take on his reaction to MATCHBOX 20, If You're Gone.
Yeah, should be. If you're gone, what will happen if you're gone?
You know better.
Yeah, so that's what I'm guessing the song is going to be about. Nothing new really. If it's it's going to be about
story. Yeah.
So let's see how the music and vocals go in this. The tune. If it was as good as the last one, it would be fun, wouldn't it? Has it started?
No, not yet.
I'm finally scared now. You think I'm weak. I think you're wrong. I think you're already leaving. Feels like your hand is on the door. I thought this place was an empire. Now I'm relaxed. I can't be sure. And I think you're so mean. I think we should try. I think I can need this in my life. And I think I'm scared. I think too much. I know it's wrong. It's a problem I'm feeling. If you're gone, maybe it's time to come home. There's an awful lot of breathing room, but I can hardly move. If you're gone, baby, you need to come home. Come home. There's a little bit of something in me and everything in you. I bet you're hard to get over. I bet the room just won't shine. I bet my hands I can stay here. And I bet you need more than you mind. And I think you're so mean. I think we should try. I think I can need this in my life. I think I'm just scared that I know too much. I can't relate, and that's a problem I'm feeling. If you're gone, maybe it's time to come home. There's an awful lot of breathing room, but I can hardly move. If you're gone, baby, you need to come home. Come home. There's a little bit of something in me and everything in my life. And I think I'm scared. Do I talk too much? I know it's wrong. It's a problem I'm dealing. If you're gone, and maybe it's time to come home. Well, there's an awful lot of breathing room, but I can hardly move. You come home, oh, come home. There's a little bit of something in me and everything in you. Something in me, everything in something in you.
beautiful, beautiful. Very well said. There's a lot of breathing room, but I can hardly move. That line is very nice. Easily relatable to many couples and many people who live in together. Yeah, you may have a lot of breathing room when they leave, but you feel the absence. You can barely move. Your life becomes empty. Nice, nice song. What are your thoughts, Kirti?
I like everything about the song. To be very honest, it's all about the lyrics of the song and the way he sang it. Is the way he sang it. I wasn't really paying attention to the music, though the music was very, very good. For me to like the song entirely, the music was good. I like the way he sang the entire song with completely being in the position of the person, making him feel what a person would feel at that moment. The way it was sung was just awfully beautiful, if that makes sense. Both opposites, but that's how it is. He made complete sense of the song. You get it on the first go. You know, there are songs which mean a lot, but you don't get it after listening to it the entire song. But this is when, you know, 30% of the song and you know what's happening to you. And I like the way the lyrics are written. All aspects have been put in there. Very beautifully, not taking too much time, not trying to beat around the bush. But almost everything has been put in there. All the emotions that come through a person's mind, all the things that, you know, rush through their mind. Maybe I need this. Maybe, you know, this is what will straighten my life out. She's going. Maybe I need something. A break kind of a thing. But at the same time, he's saying no. At the same time, he's blaming her. You're me. But at the same time, he needs her. You know, all of those things. You're trying to make peace with it. But then end of the day, you realize, is it the right thing that is happening or not? So it's the right way of putting lyrics in, you know, writing lyrics, because you're not just painting it black or white. There are a lot of things that happen or go through a person's mind. Your mind is just, you know, running. Nothing is faster than somebody's mind. There is nothing that can run faster than a person's mind, a person's imagination. And I like that reflection in the lyrics. At one point he's thinking that, on the other side he's thinking something else. Maybe she doesn't need this. Maybe I don't need her. Maybe I'll do without her. She's just being selfish. She's just being mean to me. I don't like her. But at the same time he's saying, if you leave, you must come back because I need you. There is everything me has something of you, something like that. Was also there. So I like this, the way it was written, beautifully sung, and it happens, just like you said, awful lot of breathing space, but you can hardly feel yourself in it, because your purpose is lost. You don't know what exactly to do after that.
Yeah, and it's a question mark kind of song, so I think they're still together.
Yeah, they're together.
Yeah, we're at the time of writing.
But it's his reflection.
She's just thinking about it, about it, how it would be.
Yeah.
Yeah.
If you're gone.
Mm. So we move to the last song on our list now, and we'll be back in 8 seconds for that one.
Namaste YouTube, welcome to Cafe Enoma and welcome to our first time single take on his reaction to Dan Fogelberg. This is the first time we are going to listen to Dan Fogelberg, and the song is Leader of the Band. These three songs are requested by our patron Rich, and let's listen to the music and know what.
Yeah, this is the first time
Dan Fogelberg is for
this artist, not just the song, but this artist or band in our lives. So that's very important to mention. We'll be giving an open, honest reaction no matter what.
Yes.
Whether we like it or we don't like it. You don't like hearing negative reviews? If you think this is going to be one, stay away.
Child alone and wild, a cabinet maker's son. His hands were meant for different work, and his heart was known to none. He left his home and went his lone and solitary way, and he gave to me a gift I know I never can repay. A quiet man of music denied a simpler fate. He tried to be a soldier once, but his music wouldn't wait. He earned his love through discipline, a thundering velvet hand. His gentle means of sculpting souls took me years to understand. The leader of the band is tired and his eyes are growing old, but his blood runs through my instrument and his song is in my soul. My life has been a poor attempt to imitate the man. I'm just a living legacy to the leader of the band. My brother's lives were different, for they heard another call. One went to Chicago and the other to St. Paul. And I'm in Colorado when I'm not in some hotel, living out this life I've chose and come to know so well. I love you near enough. The leader of the band is tired and his eyes are growing old, but his blood runs through my instrument and his song is in my soul. My life has been a poor attempt to imitate the man. I'm just a living legacy to the leader of the band. I am a living legacy to the leader of the
FOGELBERG.
Yeah.
Wow. First time I'm hearing this artist. Might be a band, not really sure.
Yeah.
But because there were two voices for some part of the song. Beautifully done. What are your thoughts on this?
I like the music and I like the voice. Both of them I liked a lot, and I like the story as well. His voice is very calming, very soothing, relaxing, at least in this song. You can end up listening to it almost every day. Wake up, go to sleep, anytime music this is. Just enjoy the music. I like the acoustic guitar most part of the songs. It was accompanying his voice. And then there was some instrument, maybe an organ, maybe something done on the keyboard, that just came sometimes and went towards the end of the things. At the end also it came back. And it's the story of the leader of the band whose legacy he's living.
Yeah, a fitting tribute to his father, beautiful tribute to his father, you know, and all that he has taught him. It's always sad when you realize your father's getting older and getting closer and closer to his grave. It's always a sad moment for a child, and especially the father is the kind of father that he's talked about in this song. Yeah, so very, very touching, emotional song, and a fitting tribute to his father. And yeah, his eyes are growing older, he is growing older, but his music, his legacy is living on in his son. The other two sons took a different direction in their lives.
One is in St. Paul.
St. Paul, probably the university or a priest, maybe a skirt church or something like that. And one is in Chicago, right?
Yeah, but he's in Colorado.
Yeah, and this was like a country music song. Actually.
Yeah, it actually sounds
when
like
it started, the way it went, also the story and all. Mm-hmm. We've heard so many of those in Brad Paisley songs as well as so many of the others we've heard. Yeah. Pretty similar, you know, the way it goes, sharing the story.
His voice is different though.
Yeah, voices of a rock musician, of a rock singer.
Yeah.
Not a country music. The accent isn't there. Of country musicians. That's a vital difference. But the song, the structure, the lyric writing, everything sounded more like a country music song. Yeah, it's beautiful, beautiful.
Someone
love,
was made
song.
For music.
Yeah.
No matter what was happening, he was made for music.
And our fathers play a vital role in shaping our lives. You know, who we are today. Fathers and mothers, obviously both.
Yeah.
So when the father does a phenomenal job, you know, the children automatically shine in their future. Mothers always, always do a phenomenal job, but fathers, not always. So when a father actually is there, actually tells stories, teaches the right things, makes sure that he's a good role model to the kids, does make a difference, does make a big difference to the lives of the children in the future.
You know, you find a lot of people singing about, talking about their mothers through their music, through their work. But very rarely you come across songs that also glorify fathers and the memories of your father. And that happens only in those cases where the father actually spent a lot of time with the children during their childhood. Or during whatever growing age.
Yeah.
They had a lot of moments, a lot of experiences together. The father was very vital in their growth.
Yeah, that's it. That's a really valid point. If they're not there during their childhood,
nobody sings about.
And they won't sing something good anyway.
They
won't be singing something good.
Yeah.
It will be something like Janie's Got a Gun kind of thing.
Yeah.
Yeah. Wow. Well, that's it, I guess. That's it. Not really much to say about it more. It's already said. Beautiful song. And if you'd like to learn more about us, check out our Patreon page, link in the description box below.
Thank you for watching.